Hello, everybody. Today, let's take a look and a listen to Verdi's Requiem, the very special event that San Diego Opera is presenting in our 2014 season. The first question on some of your minds will surely be exactly just what is a requiem, and that's easily answered. It's the ritual or liturgy directed by the Catholic Church for the Mass meant to celebrate the life of someone who's passed away, someone who's died. It's the text, in other words, of the funeral Mass. The concept of having a special Mass for Christians who've died goes back to the 2nd century, but the texts that eventually became the Requiem as we know it only began to coalesce between the 10th and the 14th centuries. At that time, and well up until the 20th century, those texts were in the Latin language, the official language of the Church. In monasteries, convents, cathedrals, and churches all over the world, the Latin Requiem Mass was almost always sung using traditional chant melodies. Take a listen to this, for instance, the traditional chant for the hymn Dies Irae, the text often considered the central portion of the Requiem. The text of this hymn, Dies Irae, or Day of Wrath, was considered too dark and hopeless by the Church, and it was eventually dropped from the official liturgy for funeral rites about 50 years ago. That was as a result to the Second Vatican Council. But concert settings of the Requiem by composers like Mozart, Cherubini, Berlioz, and Verdi all include that hymn, and it gave them the opportunity for striking dramatic effect. Notice that all the composers I just mentioned were opera composers. Even Benjamin Britten, a composer of a great Requiem in the 20th century, was also an opera composer. The texts of the Requiem gave these composers free rein to be as theatrical as possible, but without the artifice of costumes, sets, lighting, and special effects. There are no characters in a Requiem, and it's not staged like a traditional opera, although there are some contemporary directors who've tinkered with doing just that. But no, the Requiem as a concert piece is what we call an oratorio, a large-scale work for orchestra, chorus, and soloists meant for the reflection or the edification of the audience. Requiems were often written for specific occasions, sorrowful events memorializing a national tragedy or the death of an important person. That's exactly what Verdi's Requiem was meant to do. The composer, Gioachino Rossini, creator of The Barber of Seville, died in 1868, and Verdi thought that it would be a great memorial to him if he and other composers joined in writing a Requiem together as an homage to this great Italian master, Rossini. Verdi completed the movement that he wanted to compose, the text Libera me, or Deliver Me, and 13 other composers began to respond with movements of their own. But the premiere of the work was canceled a few days before it was to be performed, much to Verdi's annoyance. In 1873, however, the death of the great Italian poet and patriot Alessandro Manzoni, whose works stirred the imagination of the public during the time of reunification, stimulated Verdi to complete his own Requiem. And so he set about writing the work, and it was eventually premiered at the Teatro alla Scala in 1874. Now, I haven't spoken about the Requiem texts at all, so let me take a moment to do just that. In Verdi's Requiem, there are essentially 7 movements or sections corresponding to the traditional sections of the text that we find in the traditional Catholic liturgy. But he breaks some of those texts up a bit to make things more interesting and give himself more opportunities for contrast and drama. Someone once said that Verdi's Requiem is his greatest opera. Well, that's hyperbole, of course, But there's a bit of truth to it, especially if you consider the four vocal soloists, a soprano, mezzo, tenor, and bass. Verdi is careful to give each of these vocal colors a portion of the text that match the color. For instance, the tenor gets a solo aria, if you will, in the section of the Dies Irae that is a bit more tender in feeling than the rest of that text, which is filled with darkness and foreboding. It describes the sinner, repentant before God, sighing over his sins and asking forgiveness. He asks intervention through the Virgin Mary and ultimately asks God to accept him as a stray sheep into the rightful fold. Verdi's setting musically of this text is extraordinarily human and touching. Now, on the other hand, Verdi gives the darkest and most threatening parts of the text to the bass, the vocal color that brings the most darkness to the ensemble. This section of the Dies Irae, for instance, is a great example. Here's the text: "Death and nature will marvel when the creature arises and comes before the throne of judgment." Well, that part of the text has no celestial wavering, no light, no sympathy for the sinner. And so the character of the text is perfectly lined out by the color of that bass soloist's voice.
Resurge creatura, iuric
But then Verdi gives the more hopeful, penitent passages to the women, the soprano and the mezzo-soprano soloists. In the section of the Dies Irae again, where the text petitions the Lord for forgiveness on the Day of Judgment, the composer writes some truly beautiful passages in a duet for both female soloists. But the true stars of this oratorio, Verdi's Requiem, are the chorus and orchestra. In terms of sheer decibel levels, portions of the work are just about the loudest things ever written for the concert hall. Take a listen to this, the opening of the Dies Irae, meant to conjure up images of the dead in purgatory, lamenting their condemnation, despairing that they will ever feel the presence of God again. But the work opens on the text Requiem Aeternam, grant them eternal rest, O Lord, and a more peaceful, quieter opening of any musical work in any medium would be hard to come by. So, what is the Requiem and what can it offer an audience today? Look, we're surrounded by strife in this world. Death comes at us every day off the front pages of our newspapers, from our flat-screen TVs, and overwhelms us from our electronic media. Whether we think so or not, we all need some uplift from time to time, maybe more often than that. So to my way of thinking, sometimes going to a concert hall isn't just about entertainment. It can also be about enlightenment, a few moments to lift ourselves up and out of a world clouded by conflict and dissonance. Music does indeed have the power to heal, to transform, and this world is in desperate need of transformation. A musical creation like Verdi's Requiem, in one evening, takes you from the darkness of despair to the triumph of hope and redemption. Even though it does this through a very specific Christian, indeed Catholic, prism, it can work just as effectively on people of different faiths, even non-believers, among whose number Verdi counted himself. It's an incredible artistic journey, one definitely not to be missed. I'm Nick Reveles. I'll see you at the opera.